In the criminal justice system, there is an elite squad of detectives who track down seemingly ordinary people who lead double lives. These are their stories.
Mr. Jackson? Mr. Jason Jackson? I have reason to believe that you have been living a double life.
So where would you think that?
I think I'll ask you a few questions. This outfit looks very suspicious. Where do you get them made?
I'll show you, man. And this is my mum that makes all the amazing costumes.
Hello, mum.
Hi.
God, how much time have you spent making these outfits?
A lot of years.
Yeah, thousands of hours, I'm guessing. And how much do you study the images to get these outfits? Because they're spot on.
Yes, well, I have to be with Jason. If it's not right, he'll make me unpick it and do it again. Yeah.
Jason had cancer as a young boy.
Yes.
How much do you think Michael played a part in
it? A lot. It really had a lot of influence on him, yes. That actually helped his healing as well.
How long have you been a Michael impersonator then?
I've been performing him for about 25 years.
Wow. I mean, you kind of dedicate your life to another human being, in your appearance, everything. Tell me about that.
I mean, you have to step in character. When you go on stage, you have to really believe that you are him. Mm. And when you're off stage, you're yourself. But when you go on stage, you have to really make sure that the people are seeing Michael Jackson.
How are things on the girl front?
Well, not too good, but with my work schedule and in my performing, I haven't had a girlfriend, and it's sort of like with all my, you know, work and stuff, and I'm quite comfortable the way I am. But I love girls. You know, I wish a girl is mine.
Wow, no girls for me. That'd be scary. Tell me about the auction of getting this this signed poster.
They were raising money for cancer, and I bidded for this, and I got to $1,000, and I won it, and I gave $1,000 to charity.
Now, most kids would be happy if their dad built them a billy card or whatever, but your dad's actually built you your own version of Neverland.
Yes. I mean, he's built this with his bare hands. All the people, they come here to visit it. There's kids that come here. There's busloads of Chinese people that come here and visit, and they just have a great time.
Well, I do believe that children are the future.
So let's heal the world.
What was the defining moment when you became a Michael fan?
I had cancer when I was a child, and I was going to get treatment, and I heard, "Don't stop to get enough." And I just loved what I heard, and I just decided to become a Michael Jackson fan and a tribute artist.
What's your favourite MJ song and why?
Billie Jean. Billie Jean has that driving beat and got a lot of hooks in the song, which really brings the song out. And I love Billie Jean because it's a great dancing song to dance to.
What's your favourite piece of memorabilia and why?
I have to be the Michael Jackson doll. Brought out in the 1980s. I've always wanted to be just like Michael, and I would absolutely dress the doll up and just imagine that I was him.
So what's your favourite MJ dance move?
I think it would have to be the side moonwalk. I love that side moonwalk because it looks fantastic.
Why do you think you should be named Jacko's biggest fan?
I've dedicated my whole life to him since I was a child, since I was 8 years old. I've done shows and done this and that for Michael. I think that everyone is a fan of Michael.
This is all highly suspicious. I'll be keeping an eye on you, so don't leave town.
Are you Australia's biggest Michael Jackson fan? Then go to maxtv.com.au and prove it. You could win a trip for two to Sydney to the official launch party for the MJ50 birthday album. A limited edition MJ50 iPod with Michael Jackson's back catalogue. Plus the honour of being named Michael's biggest Australian fan. Go to maxtv.com.au for more details on the MJ50 files.